In the spring of 2010, Jenna Coker-Jones and Christopher Kale Jones were given the chance to change the face of music theater forever when they were cast as Seymour and Audrey in Little Shop of Horrors at the Ford's Theater in downtown Washington, D.C. Do they succeed? You decide.
Hey guys!
Hi.
Chris and Jenna here. Now we know it's been a long time since we finished doing Little Shop of Horrors.
Yes. But we have one last video we'd really like to share with you. And we actually couldn't share it until this very moment because it's a very personal story, wouldn't you say?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and it does contain nudity.
Now, as you know, Jen and I like to perform as a package deal as much as possible.
Yes.
I played Seymour and she played Audrey.
Yes.
In a Little Shop. But what you may not know is there's actually a third member of our package deal, and he really had his eyes set on playing the part of Audrey too, the plant.
And this is his story.
Save the date, so you'll have your chance. Okay, just relax.
Now listen very closely. All you need is small motion with it.
Are you paying attention?
Do you want to do this?
Because I'm not sure if you do.
I'm really doubting your dedication.
All right, fine. That's it.
Learn it yourself.
So we've got a couple options here.
Mm-hmm.
I know you're a big fan of Fender.
I am.
I know you did really good in the dance. You can't sing. You just can't sing.
Jessica, who's assisted me many times,
yeah.
I know we're considering her too. We put her in and as my assistant. She is great at making people look good. And I think
I know,
that
but can she get him to sing?
We can try. I mean, she's brilliant.
But
look
at
him. Look at that character.
I know.
He'll bring a lot to the part, boy.
Well, the first thing we gotta do is have him sing for Chris. And then
All right. Let's
go from there. But I really have reservations. I have strong reservations.
I think Paul's gonna like him because Paul wears a bow tie. And
oh,
I know he's
gonna
right. favor that.
You're absolutely right.
Hi, this is Fender.
Yeah, who's that? Oh, hi.
He's on your Super Audrey 2.
Really?
Yeah. Stay.
Me, 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 me. Me, me, me.
I think he's a little sick today. His throat was a
little
sore.
Is he on vocal rest?
I think he may be resting. He's really good.
Okay, I'm sorry. If he's not going to sing, we can't consider him. I'm so sorry. One more?
Just one more time.
Next!
Come on. I know that you were so excited and we were really looking forward to maybe you being, you know, Audrey 2 or even Seymour, actually. You came in and you really started to make yourself known as Seymour, but I just don't know that we can find the right outfit for you. And I don't know if that you're going to be able to sing the score like we need you to sing the score. So I want you to know you did a really good job, and it really doesn't have to do so much about, you know, what you can and can't do. Well, not what you can do, it's what you can't do, which is sing. But you can dance, and Karma was really rooting for you around the casting table. If it was Karma casting the show, you'd have been cast. But it's more than the dance in the show, Fender, and you know that. So, work on your music. I think a couple voice lessons would do you some real good. And then come in next time. Okay, buddy?
Turn down these voices, just hold me close. Don't patronize. Don't patronize.
Let's have applause for Fender!
To an audition to be the next Baby John in West Side Story, or you could be the next Shrek. How about Billy Elliot? Yeah, that's great. I'm so excited that you're back in the game.
But I don't know what it is. It's hard to tell. It's like that there's music playing in your ear, but the music is impossible, impossible to hear. But then I feel it move me, like a burning deep inside. Something burst in me, wide open, possible to hide. And suddenly I'm flying, flying like a bird, like electricity, electricity, sparks inside.